When your child was little, it was easy for them to show signs of love and appreciation to you. They were always hugging you and kissing you, drawing you pictures, climbing into your lap, and running to you to be held. As they got older, it seemed that some days it was harder to show how they really felt. Some days they didn't want to give you a hug, especially when their friends were watching. Some days they didn't want to talk about what happened at school. Their friends understood them so much better. Some days they just wanted to be left alone, or so they told you.
Parenting is not always easy, especially in today's hectic world. During a normal school year, it is hard to be a parent. Then you add social distancing and online learning. And not only are you parenting a sixth grader, but you are also parenting in a way no other parents have done before you. Some days it is hard to be a parent, and we know that your children don't always make it any easier for you. But whether your children have had a good day or a bad day, you, the parents, have always been there for them. You have stood by them and loved them when it was easy to do and when they were not particularly lovable. We want you to know that they love you too. We know this because they have told us in so many different ways. They are proud of you. They are no longer elementary school students. They are now middle schoolers. This part of their life is over, but tomorrow their journey starts fresh. They know that without you, they would not have made it this far. Your love and support, your sacrifices and dedication have made them who they are today.
We know that your children don't always take the time to tell you just how much they appreciate you, but they do. They don't always remember to tell you thank you, but they do. They don't always feel like saying I love you, but they do. They truly do.
We want you to know that on this day, we realize the sacrifices that you have made to send them to the best school in Tuscaloosa. Your children have received an excellent education because you have provided that for them. They will create their own futures, but you have given them the best foundation possible to move forward. We are certain that they have the background and the Christian formation to make you proud of them. We know that you will be.
As they transition into seventh grade, they will continue to look for your guidance and support. They will always need their moms and dads. Thank you for teaching them the difference between right and wrong, how to work hard, and how to achieve their goals. You have been a wonderful example for them. We know that God will bless you for being such wonderful parents.
Today, we would like to say thank you for some of the innumerable things that you have done for your children.
Thank you for worrying about them.
Thank you for bugging them.
Thank you for always standing by them.
Thank you for saving them when they had some school catastrophe.
Thank you for protecting them and guiding them.
Thank you for praying for them.
Thank you for forgiving them, even when they didn't ask for forgiveness.
Thank you for all the early mornings and the late nights.
Thank you for working so hard to make their lives easier and happier.
Thank you for helping them, even when you were tired.
Thank you for showing them the kind of people you want them to be one day.
Thank you for being their moms and dads. To our students, we would like to tell you how brokenhearted we are that we were not able to spend the end of the school year with you. You were an amazing group of students. Each and every one of you have contagious personalities, and it was hard not to love you from day one. This sixth grade class will always hold a very special place in our hearts. Our time together passed so quickly, and without a true goodbye, it just doesn't seem like our time should be over. All of you are very special to us. We can honestly say that we enjoyed every moment that we shared with you.
We would like to thank you for becoming our away from home family. You have made us feel loved and appreciated all year. You are all very thoughtful and gracious and always appreciated even the smallest kindness we showed to you. We just wish that we could have more time. We are so very proud to have been your teachers.
There are so many things that you haven't heard us say for the past 8 weeks. So here are our final words of wisdom to guide you into the next school year.
Study.
Do all of your homework.
Use your planner, please.
Read your textbooks.
Look over your notes daily.
Ask questions.
Work and rework math problems.
Read.
Make mistakes and learn from them.
Be nice.
Remember who you are.
Have fun.
Work on your Alex.
Be kind to others.
Laugh out loud.
Remember that God has a plan for you.
Never forget that we believe in you.
Pray continuously.
Seek the good in others and in yourself.
Be a friend to someone who needs a friend.
Be optimistic.
Believe in yourself.
Never settle for anything less than the best you can do.
Be your own person.
Read your Bible.
Go to church.
Thank God for your blessings.
Follow your heart.
Live your life to the fullest.
Turn all your dreams into realities.
Each one of you has the ability to be successful in middle school. Meet the challenge. We look forward to hearing about all of your successes.
Good luck, seventh graders. We love you all, and we will miss you very much. Have a great summer and an awesome seventh grade year.